So good evening, everyone. My name is Prakash. I'm part of William O'Neill India Research Equity Research Team. With me, I have Pratik Khandelwal and Nehal Mittal, who will be helping me with the PPT. So this PPT is about explaining the basics of CAN-SLIM methodology, which was developed by William O'Neill by doing research on mostly US stocks more than 50 years ago, and he did backtesting, extensive research on charting, and that way developed this technical and fundamental, a mixture of technical and fundamental strategies. So before I go further, can I please have a little bit understanding of what you guys already know about in stock markets, and what exactly have you been trading or not been trading, or what type of investing have you followed, how many years into the market? So because of the disturbance, we're not allowing to unmute, so please ping us on chat so we'll have some communication over the chat only. So so we see Sushant is complete beginner, so that's perfectly fine.
Actually, we are asking this question because it will help us in knowing the kind of crowd we are addressing, and accordingly we will either discuss it in more details, or we'll just give you the brief about the CAN-SLIM strategy and what we're expected to do in the competition.
Okay, so I understand all of you are MBA graduate, is that it, or is there somebody who is just from any other engineering or any other background which is non-MBA or not exposure into the financial analysis of companies, etc., even in the academics? Okay, so we have Pratyush with engineering bank background, which is completely fine. I think mostly we have a mixture of audience, but mostly most of you do not have extensive experience in stock market, so I'll keep that as a note. And Shubham here have some experience in stock market, and we'll just start now. So this is supposed to be basics webinar for the CAN-SLIM investing system, which I already mentioned, which is a specialized and bit different from all the approaches that you see around you, even if some of you have some any experience. So what we have here is some developed strategy, which was researched and backtested in US stocks and was then developed by William O'Neill, which was the founder of Investors Business Daily, the biggest investing newspaper in America, and also and a lot of other businesses around that. So this is a strategy. You must have known the fundamental analysis, which is the backbone of value investing, or the valuation, which is done by the rigorous company analysis, knowing the financial performance of the company and knowing other information about the business. So basically, when you invest in a company, you own a business and you need to know how the business is going to perform, and to know that, you need to know a lot of parameters which help you do the analysis. So that's fundamental. But with time and with the development of capital markets, a new form of trading has also evolved, which is called as trading. So it's mostly based on the charting patterns, how the stock move in a particular fashion during a particular time, and what sort of pattern it is making. So a rigorous research has shown that there have been some predictions possible using just the charting analysis, using the historical charts of a stock or an index or even commodity or currency, and on the price volume action and other mathematical parameters. Using all those, it's possible to predict price movement to some extent. So that's the technical analysis. What we have here in CAN-SLIM is a mixture of both, and something even more intriguing than that and useful than that. So we'll start with a disclaimer. So this content, the content in this presentation should not be considered as a recommendation to buy or sell a security. All the information is intended for educational purposes only, and in no way should be considered as investment advice. So we'll be using a couple of examples, couple of charts of companies. We'll talk about companies, give examples, just to let you know and explain how our methodology works. But these are not in any way not the recommendation that we are making. We will not be making any recommendation on official note here, and this is entirely for academic purposes. So about the agenda of today's webinar session, we'll first go through the pitfalls of conventional investing wisdom and canceling investing system. So I'll explain you what conventional investing approaches are there, what philosophy that a lot of people around us use, and how canceling system is different than that. And then we'll go into the charting system and the charting patterns and the technical analysis part of the canceling itself. So we'll tell you what kind of charts we use in canceling methodology for timing the buy and sell decisions. So let's start with the first section, and in which I'll tell you what exactly is different in the canceling or the Markets with India approach than the conventional approach. So a conventional approach is a very simple example we see and hear around is buy low and sell high. Stock market is just about buying low and selling high. That's how you make profits. And whenever a stock is falling, whenever a stock is cheap, just buy on the dip because it's trading cheap. It'll anyway go up. A stock was trading 200 3 months ago. It's now 150. There must be something wrong. It'll again come back to 200. Let's buy it cheap. So 50 rupees will easily earn. That's the conventional approach we see around. This is also immature in many sense, which I'll explain you how. But first, what philosophy do we in Markets with India follow? Is the philosophy of buying high and selling even higher. That's how increasing the chances of profit and minimizing the risks around. So we follow this strategy of buying on the way up and never on the way down. So whenever the stock is falling, it might be selling cheap than its entire life levels, but we never catch the falling life. We never do that, and we always try to buy when this stock is already in momentum, it's going up, and we just ride the upward momentum of the stock and never try to catch going down. So why do we use this approach, buy high and sell high, while it's a very conventional system tells us that buying on dips is getting the stock cheaper and getting the equity in any company very cheaper. So why do not we use that approach? Because when a stock is falling, we never try to touch it because it's next to impossible to spot the bottom. So if some of you have had any experience in stock market, you'll know that it seems easier for a newcomer or beginner in market that, okay, the stock Nifty is falling, Nifty 50 index in market, if some of you know, if Nifty is falling and it has fallen to its 3 month low, it can only go up and the chances of going lower further are very less. That's the complete very big mistake that we make in conventional investing system, because it's whenever a stock or an index is falling, we never know when the bottom level is. It might come to the entire year low, and we still cannot be confident whether it's going to go up again or go further down. No level of a stock is cheaper or cheapest for it. It can go any way from any time. So it's next to impossible to spot the bottom. Some of us which have had experience know that during the crisis of 2008 and 9, Nifty corrected almost 20%. That was almost one of the biggest corrections in the entire history of Nifty. So some of us may have thought that, okay, this is the biggest correction. It is not possible to go in any way further down. But it went again 30%. some of the people then may have thought that, okay, 30% is the bottom most level, let's buy this cheap selling stocks. But it finally went down to not 50, even touched around 60% down, which was nothing to be expected of. And still it didn't just revive very quickly from there, and it stayed there. So the people who have entered in at the 20% dips or 30% dips made huge losses. So that's why we say it's next to impossible to spot the bottom. And that's why the better and less risky strategy and more effective strategy to make money that we have found by the research is the buy high and sell higher. That's what we use in our philosophy. So this is a Bharat Financial Inclusion chart. We can say, this is just to give you an example that, so when it's the other way around. So it works the other, both ways. So when this stock was going up, so this stock traded around, this is the chart of December, the entire 2016. So the stock was rallying up and it gave almost return from here, if you can see my cursor, for 457 to 634, that is almost 40% returns. 40% returns within 3 months is explosive return for any stock. And people might have exited the stock seeing that there's a small correction over here and that stock may not go up further again. But the stock again went up, and this time with a bit stronger momentum, and it touched almost 939 within 6 months. So a person who have bought it at around 457 and sold at 634 may have lost all this return. So that's why we say that it's difficult to spot the bottom as well as the top. People might have thought that 634 is the top because 20% return in such an accelerating manner, it's very very, very unlikely. So this is the top. But this wasn't. So that's how in real life scenarios, if you see charts of very common companies, you'll see that it's very difficult to spot the bottom of the chart. So this is the example. Now again, from here, the other way around, it worked here that it was, this is the 50 DMA line, which I'll explain you later, what is the 50 DMA. So from here, the stock corrected from this level and went down to almost 600 level. I think there was a technical glitch in the laptop, so we can continue from here. So the thing I was explaining to you was it's difficult to spot the bottom. So people might have thought, looking at that, it went up to 930. This is a very good stop, good momentum it has shown, and it has corrected from 927 levels to 591 levels down, which is almost half, not half, but 60% or 40% down. So So, and that too happened in just a month. After it picked up a little bit momentum, people may have thought they can now buy the stock at cheap level, and this is the time to invest in market. 927 level can be easily achieved from here again, and this is going way up. Now, what happened actually was this. It went down further and further again. This is a real example. And so it was very likely from here to see that this is the bottom, it is going way up, and we can invest in the stock very cheap level. And this around 40-50% returns can be easily made by, because it can be easily reclaim the 900 level, but it went down again. So just to give you an example that it's difficult, not only difficult, next to impossible to spot the bottom. Now, again, this is a simple math I want to show you about for the falling stock to reclaim the same level. It's very difficult. It's a simple math. So if a stock is, let's say, trading at 100 rupees, its stock falls by 10%, we think that to reclaim the level of 100, the fallen 10%, it'll be the same effort. It's actually even more than that. The stock will have to go 11% from going back from 90 to 100. That's the simple math. And if it goes from 10 to from 100 to 20, from 100 to 80, 20% down, to again reclaim the 100 level, it'll have to move by 25%. So this is a simple math. So a stock just going from 100 to 50, it's not the same effort for it to go to 50 to 100. 50 to 100 is gaining 100%. And 100 to 50 is losing 50%. So you can see it's difficult for a stock to reclaim the level after it has fallen. So, but for the moving up stock, it's easier for the stock to gain the similar amount in numbers, because the percentage term it's lower. So with momentum, you see the up movement increases, while with the downside, the chances of reclaiming the same level are very thin. So again, this is just an example I like to give you. So when we see buy high, when we say buy high and sell high, what we mean is that there are some good performance stock and good performing company, and there are some worst performing stock and worst performing companies. So the stock which have fallen very sharply in previous some sessions or previous some time, there is a reason why it has fallen. There must be some management issue, some issue with the business model of the company, some market share they are not able to claim or not able to capture, or there something in systematic about the company and the business model. That's why it is selling lower. And if we want to enter that company, we are entering into a low quality stock. And just to give you an example, if you think about a class and a stock, and in stock as the students, if the students among the students, if there are some top performing students and there are some not so good performing students, so which one of you would bet on the so which of the student will you bet for the class to perform? Like, which one would you think that will perform better in the next class? Of course, the ones who have always been performing well, because those are the people who have shown their diligence and they have established their credibility, and they'll keep on performing. And it's very thin chances that somebody who was not performing in the previous few time suddenly become a top performer. Although it's possible, but it's next to impossible, and it's very thin chances. So that's the reason. Companies which are performing good, which have a good management, which have a good internal business strategy, which have a good take for capturing the market that they are in and fighting with the competition that they have. So if a company is doing that from years, it's chances that the company will keep on doing that, and that's what makes it easier for us, or the chances are higher that a stock going up, a company performing high, will keep on performing high. So This is the quote from William O'Neill. What seems too high and risky to the majority generally goes higher, and what seems low and cheap generally goes lower. So it's a psychological barrier that we make when we think that the stock has doubled and we think that it's become too risky and we should not invest in this stock because it has already gone higher, then chances are that it will fall. So the thing is, in actual market, what happens is if a stock is going up, it's because there's something fundamentally good with the company, and that fundamental good will keep on showing in the quarterly for the results of the company, and the stock might keep on going up. And that's what happens with most of the multi-baggers. If you think most of the multi-baggers trading at 2000 rupees or even more than that, we started off at 5 or 6 rupees and they went on just to that level in just 5 and 6 years. That's what happened. So they doubled almost couple of times. They doubled more than 10 or 20 times before they became 10,000 times their initial value. So to be specific about the markets within India approach, what specific strategies that we use? We like to buy stocks which are at or near their 52 week high. Of course, the stocks which are good and because of which they are trading at 52 week high. Fundamentally good company, and because of the fundamentally good results and good earnings and good management change, etc. If because of that reason the stock is trading at 52 week high, we like to invest in that stock. And we like to invest in leading stocks in leading group. So we just not only track the market sectors, we also track the industry subsectors. So we have 197 different industry subgroups, which are much granular than the normal sectors. Like on auto sector, we divide auto sector into auto two wheelers, auto premium, and commercial vehicle, and personal vehicle, and three wheeler. So we dig deeper, and among the industry groups which are around 200 as per our categorization, we try to look for the groups which are leading the market currently, because what happens in market, which we usually see, is which is a trend everywhere in entire world, that there are some sectors or some sector groups which are performing well for a couple of months or a couple of quarters, and then some business cycle changes because of the commodity prices or some macroeconomic factors, some interest rate changes or currency or some macroeconomic, which because of which the industry group which were performing well may go back, and the groups which were performing, which were not performing so well may come up and start performing really well. So this churning keeps on happening, and this happens in any economy of the world. So for example, auto sector in the entire world is currently under pressure, and for 2 quarters it has actually shown negative growth, which is a technical recession. And in India also the auto sector has been in the backside, so it has not performed, it has dragged the market largely. And on the other hand, the IT sector recently has come on the front. It was doing well from the entire 1 year, but recently it has started even picking up. So that's what we do. We look for the groups which are performing well, and we look for the stocks on those groups which are doing better than the other stock in the same group. So the stocks in the industry which are doing better than others, or which started rallying before others, will definitely which will have chances that they'll go even further and will give the most returns. So what other things that we look for in buying decision is a proper base structure. Now what we call a base structure is a group of patterns that we have researched, and we have found out that the pattern that a stock makes just before rallying. So this has been a result of so we tested and researched almost all of the leaders or all of the multi-baggers of last 50 years and even more than that, and we researched what sort of base pattern do they make on charts? And that's what we call base structure. And we have shortlisted almost around seven base patterns, which we use as our buy trigger point. So we decide or we time our buying decision because using those patterns and a proper breakout from those patterns. And what another thing that we have in our methodology is, which you'll not find anywhere else in any other strategy by used by any portfolio manager or hedge fund manager, not in a very systematic way that we use, is a market direction. So we keep a close eye on market direction, and we are very particular about market direction. And we have a very systematic method of tracking the market, which is based on an algorithm which was designed using, again, the back-tested data. So we decide, we have four different categories of market statuses, which we decide on the basis of systematic movements of the market. Let's say for Indian market, we use Nifty 50 as representative. So on a daily basis, how exactly it is falling, how much it is gaining, how much it has gained in last 4-5 trading session, what were the volumes, and based on a lot of other factors, we decide which status is the market is in. Is the market status downtrend, then we don't usually invest, and if it's a confirmed uptrend, we usually go further, become aggressive and start investing more. And there are other stages which are in between, like uptrend under pressure, in which we start booking profits or we cut down our exposures. And so this is fact, again, out of the backtesting that we did, that the average decline of a leader is 72%. 1 out of 8 leaders will return to lead in the next bull market cycle. So this is against the coffee can investing system that some people have. So what happens is, some of the people have this philosophy that let's invest in a stock, in a good quality stock, and keep it for the entire life. But the thing is, you might get very good returns doing that. But what happens is, the maximum or 80% of the returns that the stock gives you, you can capture that return within 20% of the time which you actually kept it for. You can capture that return for 2 to 3 years, within 2 to 3 years. So why keep your money invested for long? So, and again, if a leader in the market or a multi-bagger stock was in a rally for quite a bit time, then in a next rally, again, it being in being the leading stock, it's, the chances are very thin. As you can see, 1 out of 8 leaders are the, it's 1 out of 8 leaders will return to lead the next bull market cycle. So another, moving on to conventional approach is buy and hold and buy blue chip stocks. So some of the safe minded investors might think that because Nifty 50 stocks or BSE Sensex 30 stocks are the biggest market cap stocks, and they are safe and they don't move very, they're not very volatile, they are safer to invest. And because Nifty 50 has given 15-16% CAGR, so let's just invest in them and hold them. But there is one drawback of this, that you only get the market return. And in history, if you see Nifty 50 has only given 15-16% CAGR, which is not very less, it's actually very good. But what if I were to tell you that just by a little extra research, you can increase without any additional risk, you can increase your 15-16% to 25%. You can do that by timing the market. So just not invest in the high market cap and safe companies like HDFC and hold it for the entire life, expecting that it will return like 15-16% easily. You can hold a leader, which is a good, again, HDFC is a good stock. You can hold HDFC when it is about to run. And how exactly will you know about when it is about to run is the methodology that we use in the which we'll explain in the next technical part. So you can hold and get you can enter the stock exactly when it is about to run and exit when it shows technical weakness, and that way you can earn the similar or almost similar amount in a very small time, hence giving you the multiplication of funds. So that's what we so again, this is the example to the people who are into investing only the safest of Infosys. This is the chart of Infosys back from March 15 to March 18. In 3 years, the stock has done almost nothing. Infosys is a very good company. It's an IT major and it has consistently given good earnings performance, but the stock has not moved up. So although it has given dividends, but in effective term, in a market where there were a whole lot of other companies which had given enormous returns, this particular stock, which was doing good fundamentally, has not given return. So you may have used some other safer stocks and timed them and would have gained much more returns using the methodology that we follow. Again, example of ITC, which has almost had the similar run over the similar period, over the similar time, that it didn't give much return. So it may not always be a good and efficient strategy for, it may be safer though, but it doesn't give you enough returns of just investing and holding the large cap or safe stocks. Now, this is again another conventional approach, which is strikingly different from what we use at MarketSmith India or as per the Kansler methodology. So a lot of value investors use this method of buying stocks at lower PE. PE, for those of us who don't know, PE is a price earning ratio. It is the most commonly used valuation ratio. And price to earning ratio for a company, it's a basic rule of thumb is that a company which is trading higher PE than the industry average is usually expensive, so we should sell it. And on the other hand, a company which is trading at a lower PE than the industry average or the industry group it belongs to should be bought because it's undervalued. But we have completely different approach to this. We never consider PE for buying decisions because we believe that PE is not the predictor of any price performance. It's actually the end result of previous performance or the already existing financial performance of a company. So if a PE for company is higher, there must be some reason for that higher PE, because of its growth prospect, because of its market leadership, its competency, core competencies and pricing power, etc. And if a PE for a company is lower, there must be reasons for that. So we do not see PE for buying decision because PE is something which is already factored into the market, and just using higher and lower PE and buying companies with lower PE and selling companies with higher PE may not be so wise. So to be specific about it, because we in Kansler methodology, we are a bit biased about looking for growth stocks which are growing more than 20-25% in earnings every quarter. They are reporting earnings growth of more than 20-25%. Their sales are also growing. They're expanding the market. They are launching newer products. So the companies like these will definitely have higher PE, and any value investor will shy away from investing in them. But what happens is the high PE companies are the ones which goes on and give the highest returns. So a simple example is that if you want to have performance in your stock, if you want some of your stock to accelerate and really perform and give you returns, you need to pay a premium for that. And that's what the PE is about. If you're purchasing a high PE company, it's like purchasing a Mercedes. You're giving the premium for higher performance, for better acceleration and all other things which Maruti cannot give. You can just buy it at cheap, but it'll not perform. That's what happens with the high PE stock. There's a reason why they're trading at premium, and they do deliver on that usually. So again, to reiterate the point, PE is an end result and not the predictor of price performance. So it's not wise to just use PE and buy and time your buy and sell decision according to that. So your a company which is doing good can undergo something which is called as PE expansion, which happens in growth stocks which have even better prospect with good management, which announces some new changes in their business strategy or new products. So PE expansion is a phenomena that we take advantage from on a usual basis. So just to give you a fact, model book stocks that we track experience on average a PE expansion of 130% from first stage base pivot. I'll explain you what base pivot price means, but 130% PE expansion is something which is not normal for any value investor to see. Any value investor will hardly touch that stock with such a high PE, but we do not look at the PE value price earning ratio, and we just look at the growth numbers, fundamental story, and the technical part of it. Hemant has query about model book and pivot price. So as I said, I'll explain later what pivot price is. Model book is the book of stocks that we keep track on and we keep investing in adding. So that's what model book is about. And for the queries, if you have any queries about the anything about the PPT or anything related to that, we'll take that query after usual breaks, and just keep your queries post. Just keep note of your queries, and we'll take them all together at the end of the session, or in between we'll take a break. So it'll be difficult for me to address the query on ad hoc basis. So I was talking about PE ratios and some examples. So Aurobindo Pharma was trading at PE of 51 at around September 2004, which is a very high PE for any industry across any standards. But with the PE from the PE of 51, it went up 313%. No value investor would have invested in that. Nobody using DCF valuation, discounted cash flow valuation, if you know about from your academics, that nobody would have created a buy signal or for Aurobindo Pharma or even for Wipro, which was trading at 69. Because very explosive, their growth assumption number must have been taken in order to, you know, generate a buy decision for stocks with such a PE. But still, these stocks went up, and this is again contradictory to the usual philosophy of PE. And these are very common stocks. These are not stocks from the stocks which are very uncommon or penny stocks. These are the stocks which were doing really well. Wipro gained 375% from 1998 to 2000, and it is one of the leading IT major now. So these are the companies which represent the entire market. So another philosophy that some of the value investor or only the fundamental investors who only think that the financial statements and business model of the company is the one which can give you information about the company, and they think that the technical analysis or the using chart for buying, timing your buy and sell decision is actually a bunch of nonsense, because in technical analysis we assume that the historical chart patterns will go on and repeat. And so they think that it's nonsensical. Just detect and research and shortlist the good stocks, good fundamental stocks through their earnings, their financial statement, their management commentaries, and etc. And just invest in them and hold on to them. But they are half in their part. They're right in half. But the thing is, what happens with good companies, even finding the good companies, that they might give you returns, but if you don't know how to time the market and how exactly when to enter and when to exit the stock, the amount of returns over time that we earn, or the annualized return that we get, will be very, very bare minimum, or not as much, not very attractive. So half of the thing that they're very right in, half of their philosophy, that that fundamental analysis is the single biggest important thing about knowing a stock and knowing or shortlisting the stock of watch list which you want to invest in. But how exactly you should enter, when exactly you should enter, when you should exit, you should use charting system for that. So that's what we do. We use fundamental analysis for shortlisting the stocks, for making our watch list, the stocks that we will invest in. But when exactly to buy and sell, we make that decision using charts. And that exceptionally helps us to exceptionally outperform the entire market. So what exactly are charts about and what do they reveal? Charts, basically, if you know, chart is nothing but a price against time chart, if you don't have any experience of looking at the chart. So very common chart would be a line chart of a price, of price of the stock and against time. And what, and another element which is very important in the chart is the volume. So with what volume the trading happened on a particular day is also revealed some action about the stock. So what we have, what we do is, and what charts usually reveal is the institutional demand. So as you know, or some of you might know, that most of the trading volume that happens in the entire world, or even in US, is done by the institutional investor, and the retail participation is very minimal, or the very less. And if we talk about India, it's very thin, even very thin. So the people who move the market are usually institutions, which can be foreign institutional investors, Indian mutual funds or pension funds or insurance companies, insurance funds. So these are the institutions which move the market. And the chart patterns, the specific pattern that the charts make, can actually help you detect when the institutions are exiting or entering the market, and that will be very important decision that can be very instrumental to your buying and selling decision. So that can help us time the market well. So again, this is about the buying on dips thing, which conventional approach comes with, that when the market is in a downtrend, it's good time to find buy bargains. That's what the conventional approach is. But again, as we explained, it's next to impossible to find the bottom of the market, and you can actually lose further, because a falling market can go on to make lower lows further and further. So the chances are very thin that you'll make money buying stocks when the market is falling. You can wait for the market to stop falling and start recovering, and wait for that, and then maybe try to enter the market. That's even safer strategy. You might lose very minimal of the returns, but that's very effective in terms of risk. So in risk reward terms, you'll be better off with not trying to outsmart a bear, because the odds are not in your favor. So that's what we do. We never try to catch the falling knife, and we wait for the bear market to subside. We wait for the bottom to be made, and we wait for the upward momentum. And if it is confirmed according to our own objective framework and the parameters that we use, which we'll explain later in the market part. So if it comes to the confirmed uptrend, then only we enter into the market. So some of the conclusion from this section. So we discussed about the fact and research part of the conventional wisdom. So what some conventional wisdom are, and against that, what we use here in Market Myth, and what are the logical and empirical basis of us using those approaches. Now, conventional approach may work some of the time, but you know, the market is not about earning money today. Market is about how much you can earn over years, and it's about, so
So then it becomes a game of probability. You might earn something big today using the conventional approach, but what can this approach be consistent? Can it mitigate risk over the long period of time? So everything becomes probabilistic in the longer run. So that's when the back-tested strategy of canceling comes in, where the proven rules, which if you follow well and with dedication and discipline, you can increase your chances of success. Now for the next part, I'll invite my colleague Nehal for explaining it further. So she'll be explaining about canceling. So.
So if you have any queries for the first part, you can ask us right now.
Ping us on the chat and we'll take a short
break. Yeah, we'll take a short break at around 5:15, 5:30, between 5:15 to 5:30.
So before that, can you please post your queries so that we can take up the queries from section 1?
Or maybe we can have a 15 minutes of question and answers session right now and a break of 5 minutes. And kindly ask the question to all of, in the chat box. Don't ask it in a private mode because they want everyone to listen to the questions and the answers. So pivot price, we will explain when we will be explaining the technical analysis, when we will explain the chart patterns, then we will talk about the pivot price. Anyways, we don't see any questions, so we'll start with the canceling now.
Good evening, everyone. So my name is Nehal. I work for William O'Neill India. So I'll be taking you through canceling. So basically, my colleague Prakash has talked about what are the wrong ways of investing. The question which might be surrounding you is that what is the right way in which we must invest. So we'll be talking about CAN-SLIM, which will be a very great understanding of stock markets. And also if you are a beginner, as I guess from your profile that most of you would be beginners in stock market. So it would give you a very good starting platform so that you can start investing and be profitable from there. So now, canceling. It is just like a technique which is applied on stock markets so that we can maximize our profits there. So, So how is this canceling derived? So basically, it was derived by the owner of the firm, William O'Neill. He basically studied the most good performing stocks in about 5 decades. And then he came up with a method, like the general principles which could be applied to the stocks, which would be doing good in coming future. So this is something which has been derived from the behavior of the stock market in around 50 years. And it is a very extensive analysis to find the stocks which will be giving us better returns in coming future. So basically, there are a few books which are written by Mr. William J. O'Neill, and he's the founder of Investor Business Daily, which is one of the leading investing newspapers in US, and of course the CAN-SLIM strategy, which we'll be discussing further. So CAN-SLIM. So basically, each letter in CAN-SLIM stands for a criteria which we must look on before investing in the stocks. So C stands for current earnings, A stands for annual earnings, N stands for the new factor, S stands for supply and demand. L stands for leader versus laggard. I for institutional sponsorship, and M is the market direction. So basically, how can we say that CanSlim would be helping us? So we can say that between 1998 to 2017, the general S&P 500 gave a return of 5.2%. But if we apply the CanSlim strategies to the stocks, and we filtered few stocks which gave a return of 21.90%. So we can clearly make out that this method is about four times more effective, or it is giving us return more than four times the general in the way the general market moves. So you, as you can see, it is among the top rated techniques or analysis which must be which the investors are following in order to pick up the great stocks. Now, how did our owner develop CanSlim? This step I have already told you that it includes an extensive analysis and observation of market for 5 decades. So it is a very long time, and observing market, how it moves, how it behaves in situation of crisis, or how it behaves when something new is introduced in the market. Everything was seen, observed, and then the conclusion was drawn, and which led to development of this this technique CanSlim, which helps us in picking the profit, the more profit giving stocks. So as it is said, if you want to learn anything about fish, sit in the front of fish bowl and look at the fish. It is the same thing. If you want to learn about market, you must observe the market, and obviously you must study the indices which the market trades in, and you will know how the market behaves in the short run as well as the long run. So it is about this is how the technique was developed, and the way the market behaves, the way the stock behaves in the market, everything was done on an extensive manner, and the winning stocks were studied for a very long period of time, and then some few general principles were developed. So as I've already told, each alphabet in CanSlim stands for a fundamental technique which we must use, and we'll be taking up these techniques one by one. So C stands for current earnings. As the name suggests, current earnings are the earnings which the company has recorded in the recent quarters. So basically, if a earnings, you know, is relatable to the revenues. If the revenues of the companies are increasing, this clearly means that the company is doing well. This is a simple logic of business. If the company is earning more and more in coming quarters, which means they are doing something good, which is making the business do well as well. So it could be because of a new product which they have launched, or it could be the cost cutting which the company has done. But it is something positive for the company. So we focus on current earnings a lot. So as per the criteria, we say the current quarterly earnings, the growth rate of the current quarterly earnings should be 25% or more. We basically look at the past 3 quarters of the company. If the company has been doing well in the past 3 quarters and the revenue growth rate is 25% or more, we consider company has qualified this C parameter of CanSlim. Now this 25%, this might be a bit different figure in the developed markets, because the developed markets, 25% earning growth is not that much feasible as in the emerging markets. But yes, it should be double digit current earnings growth in the past 3 quarters. So now, what is the rationale behind it is, since 1953. 3 out of the top 4 best performing stocks showed an earning increase of 70% or more in the quarter right before they started their huge price moves. So which means when a company reported very good earnings, or it had maintained a very good earnings for say 2 to 3 quarters, then the huge price movement of the company started, which means the stock price of the company started gaining strength from after the quarterly results were out for that company. So as we can see, Edelweiss. So when the company reports results, like you said, after that, the company starts picking up, you can see so you can see this was a run which company took after announcing good results. So whenever a company gives current good earnings, this is taken very positively by the market, and obviously the demand for the company shares increases, which really pulls up the prices for the company stock, and this way the profitability of the people who are invested in them increases a lot. So now we'll move to the another parameter, which is annual earnings. So annual earnings is same as current earnings. Basically, the current earnings refers to the quarterly earnings or the half yearly earnings, which depends upon the earnings schedule of the company. Annual earnings is the entire financial year for which the company is reporting. Even for annual earnings, we take 25% or more growth rate in order to qualify a stock for investing. And second criterion annual earnings comes to be margins. So let me give you a simple example. The margin is the difference between a product is sold and what does it cost to a company. So if a company sells a product at 5 rupees, which may be market driven price, but a company A has cost price of 3 rupees and a company B has a cost price of 4 rupees. So we can clearly see that the company A will be having the margin of 2 rupees and company B will be having a margin of 1 rupee. And this margin is directly relatable to the profitability of the company. So if the company has good margins, the best margins in the industry, obviously it is more profitable than the other companies operating in the industry, and obviously it is going to give us huge returns in the coming future. The third criteria is the return on equity. This is something we all look for. Whatever capital we have employed, when we are investing in a company, we are basically providing them the capital to work. So if the company is able to earn good amount on our capital employed, that is what we want in return. So this is return on equity, which should be 17% for the company, which when we qualify it for the annual earnings parameter. So this is again an example when the company started gaining strength because of reporting good annual earnings. And I would like to emphasize on one more point here, that just one quarter or just one year of good earnings is not sufficient. The company must be consistent in performance, and in order to gain investors' attention towards itself, it must have at least performed good in 2 to 3 quarters, or it must have, in terms of annual earnings, it must have at least been a consistent performer from past 2 to 3 years. So this is something which must be kept in mind. Just one exceptional quarter or just one exceptional year doesn't qualify a good stock. One exceptional quarter or one exceptional year could be a one-time payment for a company which the company has received from some other source which is not core to the business of the company. So these things we must be cautious before looking into the earnings part of the company. Now N stands for new. So this new could be in terms of product, services, leadership, or anything which changes in the industry. So let me give you one example. Eicher Motors started manufacturing this agricultural tractor in 1959. So they came up with tractor for the first time, and it disrupted the entire industry. As we know, it started green revolution in India. The plugging, which was very tough in India those days, it became really easy, and you can still remember, you still know how much this Eicher tractor is valued, and this led to a huge movement in the stock prices of the company, which is very evident. If a company introduces new product, it obviously gets the first mover advantage, which will definitely help the company in profitability in the coming time. And also the new product, if it could create a demand, it will take some time to the it will take some time to the competitors to come up with a similar product, and in order to create a competition for the company. So during this time, the company could gain a lot of market share, which becomes very difficult for the competitors to gain back after they come up with a similar product. So this is the first mover advantage which a company will get if a company introduces some product which is very much in demand. So a new product cannot be something which is not much received by the customers. If a product is heavily received by the customer, then this new product could create a disruption in the industry and could be a very good signal for the profitability of the company in the coming time. And this new product will be looking at this new product definitely as a criteria to invest in the stocks. Now the same things with Britannia Industries. So what happened was the company used to derive 70% of its revenues from biscuits, and which has a market share of around 28%. So now they didn't introduce any new biscuit, but it was something the change at the management level which helped the shares of the company to grow. So basically, any new person which has a lot of experience in that particular domain or in that particular industry comes up as CEO, then the knowledge which the person brings to it can be very useful for the company. And this new CEO, which was Mr. Varun from PepsiCo India, has already done very well in PepsiCo, and it has taken Pepsi's market share from 2% to 40% in single year. So this was taken very positively by the market, as the person could do the same for Britannia as well. And this lifted the share price of the company to a great extent. So this new product, new CEO, this new factor is really important when we look at the company. If the company is going to develop something new, then it could be a great puller for the stock price of the company. This is another example of Ajanta Pharma, which is one of the leading pharmaceutical companies. So basically the company have there are a few things which the company introduced for the first time in the market, and this helped the company to grow at a CAGR of 46%, and this obviously would have pulled the stock price of the company to a great extent. Because any company which is growing, which is having profitability, if a company is gaining profit, that is ultimately passed on to the shareholders. And if the company is prospect of gaining profit in the near future as well, so there would be more shareholders which would be interested in the company, which will pull the demand of the company up, which will definitely drive the prices in the upward direction. New price hikes. So this is a bit of the technical thing. New price hikes is basically when a company starts forming, when a company starts taking up the prices on a chart pattern. So basically, what is a 52-week high is the highest level the stock price of the company has achieved in, say, 1 year. So if the company is near its 52-week high, which means the company has gained momentum to come to that level. And obviously, this momentum is because of some fundamental reason, which could be either a very good quarterly earnings, which could be either because of some new products which is developed by the company, which is going to sustain for the coming time. So if the company is forming new price highs, this is a very, very good sign. And obviously, the price highs are generally formed when the company is in a consolidation and it breaks out of that. So basically, here I would like to show you that. So here we can see that the company was consolidating for a long time. The company has been consolidating here for a long time. So then it started picking up the momentum and it hit its 52-week high, and then you can see the momentum which followed. So basically, if the company is touching its new 52-week high, even that is considered as a new thing for the company, and this is going to pull the stock price higher in coming time. So basically, just give me a second, please. Yeah. Yeah, so this is something new which we must looking at the company. Next cancelling criteria is S, which is for supply and demand. So this is the simple rule of economics, what we study. That if, see, like what I want to show you here is, you can have a look at the Shimano Entertainment chart. Now one thing which you must notice here is, these blue are the days when the stock price goes up, and pink one are the days when the stock price comes down. So basically, one wonderful, what we can say, observation from this chart can be, when the price was going up, the volumes were very high. Can you see that these are the volumes? These are very high. And when the price was pulling down, which means on the pink days, the volumes were really low. So the volumes were low on these days and it was really high on the blue days. So what does this mean? Whenever the stock is gaining price, it is on high volumes, which means whenever the stock is picking up price, people are demanding for more of the stock. And whenever the whenever the stock price is getting dropped, people are volume is less, which means people are not panicking to sell that stock. Volumes are less, which means the volume traded is less on that particular day in the stock exchange. Which means if the stock is falling, few people might get panicked and sell the stock. But if the volumes are less, which means people are not panicking and the stock is not being sold to that extent, which clearly means that people still have a faith in the stock, which is a very positive sign. So this is the demand and supply rule, where we can see that whenever the stock is pulling up, it must show good volumes, and whenever the stock is pulling down, we must see a dry up in the volumes, so that we can be convinced to the fact that people have a positive sentiment around this stock. Whenever the stock is going up, people are buying more of it, which means it is a positive sentiment associated with the stock, that the stock is going to further going to escalate. And if the people are not selling on a pink day, which means people still have faith in the stock, that stock is going to stock is not going to deteriorate further, and of course it is going to show us a momentum in the coming time. As we can see, even after this pink day, there were there was blue days which showed a great momentum in the stock. And this clearly gives the quality of a great stock in the market. Now, L is for leaders and laggards. So what does this mean? That we must buy the leaders. Leaders as in a particular industry. The companies which are doing good, the companies which are doing best must be bought by us. So basically, what does it mean? Suppose we have a particular industry space and 10 companies are operating there. There would be few companies which will be having good EPS growth rate, good sales growth rate, better margins than the other companies. So we must focus on the companies which have this good EPS, sales, price performance, margins. So that we know that whenever the industry is going to grow, these would be the companies which will benefit the most. And whenever something worse happened to the industries, these companies would have cushion so that they are impacted the less. So we must clearly identify what are the leaders in that particular industry group, what are the laggards companies in that particular industry group, and we must focus on the companies which are leader in their industry group or which are doing very well in that particular industry group, and we must focus them for investment purpose. Now, I, institutional sponsorship. This is one of the very important factor in CAMSLIP. As we know, retail investing is a very small part of the overall investing which takes place in the market. So this and these institutional sponsors, they buy stocks which are in say crores of Indian rupees, which is not the case with retail investors. So these institutional sponsors are the movers of the market. They basically determine the direction in which the stock will be moving. So if the institutional sponsorship is increasing for a company, which means more and more institutional sponsors are having faith in that company's future and they are investing their money, and that is a lot of money. So these institutional sponsors, they do a lot of due diligence before getting invested in some company. So we must clearly focus on this point. If the institutional sponsorship is rising, which means institutions are gaining more and more faith about that company, and they are investing more and more of their money in that company. So with this factor must be taken into consideration. We must look for the companies for which institutional sponsorship has been rising for some quarters, and then we can make a better informed investing decision. So that's what I'll like to show you here, that the institutional sponsorship here, this is the, just a second. I would like you all to see this institutional, the funds, which is the bottom part of the slide, the funds section. As we see, in June 17, it was 90. Then in September 17, it was 91. And in December, it became 87. So consequently, we see that the stock has been gaining momentum initially. And from December, when the institutional sponsorship dropped, even the stock became stagnant and it didn't show much upward movement. So this is something which must be focused on. So whenever the institutional sponsorship for a stock is dying, which means institutional are losing their faith in the stock, and that would be definitely because of some reason, because these are the sponsors which do a lot of due diligence before investing, and they invest a lot of money. And that is the reason, if they're taking out the money, which means either the industry conditions or the company conditions are going to worse. And we must be very careful and we must be very informed about the institutional sponsorship which is taking place for that company. Now, one of the important criteria is the market direction. It is generally said 3 out of 4 stocks follow the general market condition. Now, what is market composed of? Nifty 50, Sensex 30. It is just an index of the stocks which constitute it. So if Nifty is going down, which means the stocks which constitute Nifty 50 are going down. So if the stocks are going down, which means Nifty 50 is going down, which implies to the other stocks as well, which are not a part of Nifty 50. So On a weekday when the market goes down, most of the stocks will follow the same thing, the same pattern which the market follows. Now we have the 4 market conditions, which is confirmed uptrend, uptrend under pressure, downtrend, and a rally attempt. So confirmed uptrend is when the market has been showing good strength and momentum for past few weeks. And we can say that the market, this momentum is going to continue, and we must buy stocks here. So basically, these 4 directions, these move in a cycle. So let us start with explaining these market conditions. So basically, let's say the market starts with a confirmed uptrend, which means they have been gaining momentum. and this is the ideal time when we must buy the stocks. Now, from confirmed uptrend, the market has moved to an uptrend under pressure when we see that there is loss of distribution taking place. What is a distribution day? As we define, when the market falls, when a market falls on higher volumes. What does it mean? Although the market fell, the prices of the stocks were less, but the volume was good, which means the people are panicking and they want to sell off the stocks which they are holding. So this is a distribution day in the market. So if we encounter 4 to 6 distribution days, we move the market from a confirmed uptrend to an uptrend under pressure, which means the market is facing a pressure towards the selling side. Now from uptrend under pressure, we move the market to a downtrend. Downtrend is when more distribution days get added or if the market breaches any of its key support levels. Now, what are these key support levels? These are like the 50-day moving average or 100-day moving average, which would be taken up later in the presentation. So if the market breaches any of its key support level or the distribution day pile go on increasing, then we add the market to a downtrend. Now from a downtrend, if the market shows some momentum and for consecutively 3 days, it shows good strength and it doesn't breach the low which has formed in downtrend, we move the market to a rally attempt. And from rally attempt, if the market further shows strength, then we can move it to a confirmed uptrend. And if the market doesn't show strength from a rally attempt, then we move the market back to downtrend. So now, what is the application for these market conditions for you guys? We must be investing ideally in the confirmed uptrend. In uptrend under pressure, we must get cautious and we must look at our portfolio and the stocks which are even performing worse than the markets must be sold off. And in downtrend, we must not be adding positions. We must not be buying any more stocks. In downtrend, in order to minimize our losses, we must be focusing on the sell side. During the rally attempt, we know if the market shows more momentum, it would move to a confirmed uptrend. In rally attempt, we must start looking out for the stocks which have been doing good or which have been outperforming the market, and then we can take up a decision. And this is how we must think. If the market, based on the condition in which the market is, how our investment should be there. We must invest in confirmed uptrend. We must not invest in downtrend. In uptrend under pressure, we must be cautious. And in rally attempt, we must be looking out for the stocks which we may add to our portfolio. So it says buy only during a confirmed uptrend and all bets are off when the market is in a downtrend. So now this brings us to the end of the cancelling criteria. Now we'll be taking up the technical things, technical chart patterns and everything which are there. And before that, if you have any doubts till this, you can bring us your doubts and we'll be giving a break shortly. Or guys, we can do one thing. We can have a 10 minutes break now and then we will discuss these technical chart patterns and how we must look into the chart for investing.
So we'll start section two now. And I'm Pratik. I work with William O'Neill India and also our retail product MarketSmith as well as Swing Trader India. So I hope everyone is connected by now. Kindly ping in the chat box if you guys are connected. Otherwise, we'll wait for another 4-5 minutes. Okay, so there is a question from Sushant that how do we factor seasonality using this method and how do we know this is a bad environment for investing? Now, that's a very good question. And cancelism strategy has advantage over other strategies because we are good in identifying the market cycles. So we have our own calculations, and I think Prakash would have explained the concept of distribution day. So based on distribution day, we have segregated the market into 4 cycles. So the best time to invest is confirmed uptrend. From there, if the market degrades, it goes into uptrend under pressure. Now, uptrend under pressure is a good time to book profits or cut short your losses. From uptrend under pressure, market can again go back into rally or it can degrade to correction. Now, during correction, you will see most of the stocks falling. Your profits would erode. Now, during correction, William O'Neill says to stay away from the market. And it's mainly because 75% of the markets will, 75% of the stocks will follow the market direction. So in correction, make sure that you invest in some other avenues, but not equities. From correction, if the market conditions improve, then it will enter rally attempt. Now this is a phase when you will see market will try to get into rally, but then it will fail. You will see most of the times market will be very volatile here. Nifty would be green in the morning and suddenly red in the afternoon session. And there will be people will fall into all those traps, and it will be difficult to make money during rally attempt. However, from rally attempt, when there is a follow-through day means that when Nifty increases by 1.5% or more on a single day and the volumes should be higher than its previous trading session, if that happens, that is called a follow-through day. And follow-through day will mark the first day of confirmed uptrend. Once there is a follow-through day and you see actions in the leading stocks, by leading stock I mean top stocks in all the sectors. Say for example, when we talk about FMCG, we would like to see strong action in Britannia, Nestle. When I talk about, say for example, IT, we would like to see action, strong action in say stocks like NIIT Technology, Mindtree, Wipro, to name a few. So if you are able to see the a pickup or a strong price volume action in leading stocks, that marks a start of a new rally. So this is how cancelism strategy tells you when to invest and when not to invest. Now this is our key advantage which we have, and every time whenever there has been a correction, we are the first one to predict it, because our method is kind of, you know, we are always advanced, and based on our calculations, even after demonetization, when people were selling thinking that they're still into correction, we changed our market status into confirmed uptrend, and we actually picked that at the stocks which we picked up in the early part of 2017 helped us in, you know, pushing our portfolio return towards close to 80%. So that's the advantage of market direction, trading with the market direction. So some few people are asking for the PPT. We will not be giving the PPT. However, the recordings would be available. You can listen to it. So before explaining the base patterns, first I would like to define what are bases. So bases are nothing but a period of sideways movement. So stocks would move sideways or kind of, you know, move in a trend, in a pattern. So that patterns ultimately give up, I mean, it gets formed into a cup. So it will be called as a cup base pattern. I will show you that, you know, how does the base patterns look. It might look like a cup with a handle. So the name is cup with a handle. It will be a double bottom, or it can be flat. It can be saucer with handle, base on base. So it's basically all the names are based on the shape the sideways movement might take. So currently we will discuss the top three, that is cup with a handle, double bottom and flat base, because these are the most common and the rest four is not required now. So first we'll explain, first we'll try to understand what is a fundamental analysis and what is a technical analysis. So with fundamentals, you get into top-down as well as bottom-up analysis. In top-down, you tend to see the macroeconomic factors, how is the investment environment in a country. If a country is good for investment, then you kind of go ahead and start doing the bottom-up analysis of different companies. So in fundamentals, in bottom-up, we would be specifically focusing on the earnings of the company, because we are a growth investors. As Prakash told you, that we look for 20-25% growth, current annual earnings growth, as well as in quarterly earnings also, we expect a 20-25% earnings growth. And in a company like India, which is an emerging economy, there are a lot of companies which are delivering that kind of a return. So in CANSLIM, the CANL stands for the fundamentals, which is your current earnings. A stands for annual earnings. New is new product. L is leaders or laggards. So that will be a fundamental analysis. And in technicals, we see the supply and demand. Then leaders, whether the stock is a leader or a laggard. So leaders or laggards can be seen from technical perspective as well as fundamental perspective. I stands for institutional sponsorship. I think Nehal might have told you that why fund holding is very important, because they tend to give support. And I will explain you with the help of charts how you can identify whether big money is entering into the stock or exiting from the stock. M stands for market direction. So today Yes Bank increased, surged 30%, because it got a clean sheet from RBI that there is no divergence in their provisions, in their NIAs. So basically, because of that, Yes Bank in surge 30% today. And if you see the volumes today, you will get to know a lot of funds would have entered into the stock. So the basic chart reading, this is how a normal chart looks like. This is called as candles. So we have picked up this in a candle. This is called the high of the trading session. This is called a low, and where this will stop will be known as the closing point. So in this chart, If we particularly pick up this candle, it closed at the day's opening, which is a very strong signal. If you see this, it closed near to day's low. This again closed near to day's low. So it closed somewhere in the bottom, somewhere in the top, near the top of the day. So this is how a normal candle is being read. Now these are the price movement, and these are the volume. So this, the lower part, the lower ones which you are seeing is the volumes, and this horizontal line is very important because that's the average line. So normally we want, when the stock is moving up, whenever there is a blue bar here, we want that the volume should be above average. This blue bar should be above this red horizontal line. And when the stock is falling down, we want it to fall on below average volume. So this is what ideally we want that is a signal that there is a good amount of accumulation happening in the stock. Okay, just a second. I'll just try to sort it. Okay, so I think the problem is solved now. Yeah. So I'm explaining this particular slide again. So this is your basic chart, and these are the candlestick chart. This will be your price actions. This is the volumes, and a normal candle, how to read it is, you can see a plus symbol over here. So in this case, this vertical one will tell you the day's range from here. So this particular, say for example, any stock would have traded in this particular range. Its low was here, high was here, and this will be the close. So this, the close will be marked as a vertical candle basically. This is the volume, and this horizontal red line is called the average line, and this blue is when the stock will move up, it will show up as blue. See, the price will be blue, and when the stock will fall down, it will be shown as red. So this is very important, and normally what we want is when the stock is moving up on above average volume, when the stock is moving up, it should move up on above average. This is the average, and above average, this is the above average volume, this is the above average, or something like this we want. And when the stock is falling down, say for example, if you see this candle, the stock fell down and the volume is very much less than the average volume. So this means that weak investors are moving out of the stock, not a big fund. However, if you see something like this, that a stock is kind of breaking its support level, this red line is the 50 day moving average, this is a 200 day moving average. Now when the stock has, see for example here, it touched 200 day moving average, it does 200 day moving average, and it gapped down up on the very next day. That means a big fund exited the stock from here, and if you see the selling, it's above average. That means that earnings would have been very bad, and a big fund decided to exit the stock. So that's a basic chart reading, and as we go forward, we will just build up on this concept. So if you're not clear right now, don't worry, you will see a lot of charts today and you will be just through with the concept. So as I told you, this is the 50 day moving average line, this is your 200 day moving average line. Technically we need just these two for canceling. But then just for your information, traders who are just doing intraday tradings and even a short term or swing trading kind of a thing, they also look to 5 exponential moving average as well as 20 day exponential moving averages. Now difference between a daily moving average and exponential moving averages, exponential moving averages give higher weightage to recent days, whereas daily moving averages give equal weight to each days. The third is the relative strength line, which is the price strength line. It tell you how is the stock performing compared to the general market. So this is a weekly chart of Canfin Homes. Canfin Homes is the name of a stock, and this chart is of March 2018. If you see this chart, this particular stock, this kind of sky blue line which you are seeing is the 50 day moving average, and your red line is a 200 day moving average. So here are the price actions, here are the volume actions. So there, if you see, in 2-3 occasions, stock was going up on above average volumes. That means fund managers, mutual fund managers, foreign portfolio investors, they were buying the stock over here. And you might question that why above average volume means that big money is coming into the market. That is because retail participation is very low in India, and retail investors cannot move the market. It's the funds, big money, which is which moves the market. And if they enter, this kind of a volume will show up on this. They generally buy in such a huge quantity that there will be volume spikes, and you can see it on the chart. Now this is a daily chart. If you see the weekly chart, and now if you see daily chart is more clear and prominent. Here you can see all the things which I'll be trying to explain you. Now why institutional holding is important? So the reason is, you'll see just here. If you see here, this stock has a death cross over here. Now death cross is a point where your 50 day moving average comes below the 200 day moving average. Now this is a clear cut sell signal. If you see something like this, immediately sell this stock, because normally that means your recent, your the stock's recent trend has broken, and there is, I mean, it's into the downtrend and it can just bottom out. So it's very important to know these things, which is a golden crossover, which is death crossover. Now, just the opposite of death crossover is the golden cross. When your 50-day moving average crosses 200-day moving average steeply, so that means if 50-day moving average comes above 200-day moving average, that means it's a green sign. Go ahead and buy this stock. However, again, for canceling, you're not needed this, because I mean, as we go forward, you will know what all things are required. Just for your information, I just explained golden cross as well as death cross. So in this particular chart, if you see that this was the point where the stock tried, stock was trading below 50 DMA and a fund suddenly enters the stock. If you see the average, I mean the volume was above average. So that means that a stock going up on above average volume is a very positive sign, and it is an indication that a huge accumulation is happening in the stock. Now, another thing which you can look up to is, which will give you an indication that a buying is happening in the stock or accumulation is happening in the stock. In this case, this green, this blue color candle is higher. It's becoming, there was a selling pressure here. On three occasions it fell, it was in a downtrend. Again, it moved into an uptrend. And if you see, this buying candles are becoming bigger than this red candle. So that means that there is a strong buying happening in the stock. The other day there is a selling, but then the selling is on above average volume, but then the candle is of a small size, and also it's an indication that though a fund would have exited, however, it's still trading above the 50-day moving average line, which is a positive sign. The other day again it went up, and the volumes just touched the average line. So this is where a lot of funds they play. Prakash would have told you that averaging down is a bad concept. However, how you should average down is, you should, for example, you bought a stock at say 70 rupees, and 50-day moving average is at 65. Now, when the stock falls at 65, it's getting the support at 65. If it's getting a pullback from 65, buy the stock. You can average it over there. However, if it reaches that 50-day moving average line and it is falling below 65, don't enter the stock. That is the falling knife, and more often than not, it will hurt you. So that's how you average down. You can average down at key support levels, that is at 50-day moving average or 200-day moving average. So before most major price moves happen, the stock will make a pattern, and we'll just see those chart patterns now. And chart patterns reveal the optimum time to buy in a bull market, because see, everyone knows that HDFC Bank is a good stock, but then very few would make profit out of it. The reason being, HDFC Bank, people don't buy that particular stock at a key, key point where it is supposed to be bought. So they enter the stock at a wrong time and ultimately make losses from a fundamentally very strong stock. So now, cup with a handle base pattern, how it is formed? So for a cup with a handle base pattern, a stock should have a prior uptrend of at least 30%. So normally, say for example, any stock would have rallied for 30%. Now this, in Indian market, normally when a stock rallies for 30%, there will be some kind of a profit booking, because 30% is a good amount of profits which a person can book. So from that peak, it will fall down. When it will fall down, it can fall down from 15 to 35%. So that this the depth of this base can be from 15% to 35%. Now this entire cuff formation will take place in relatively 7 weeks. So in 49 trading session, in 7 weeks you have 35 trading sessions. So in 35 trading sessions, the entire base formation would happen. It might take a bit longer, it might take a bit less, but then the best part is the software will determine it for you. You will get the MarketSmith India app access for your research, and you can use that. You just type the name of the stock and it will automatically show up whether it is making a cup with a handle base pattern or which base pattern it is making. So you will get all those things. However, we are just trying to explain you how does it happen. So this, if you see, it looks like a cup. Now from here, what happens is people start booking profit and ultimately the stock kind of, you know, bottoms, and this is where people start bottom fishing. So again, funds enter into the stock, and this is again a good time to buy. People who are bottoming out, when the stock bottoms out, people start buying it. There is a huge buying happening in the stock. It again goes up. Now at this particular point of time, people who would have bought here, or someone who would have bought here but failed to exit here, would exit over here. So again, some weak investors will move out. At this particular point of time, guys who would have bought it here or say even here, they would kind of try to buy, add more to the position, because you know it's falling. It's a good stock. The stock, this handle formation you will see will happen when that it means that stock is falling down, and the fall you would observe on the chart will be on below. I mean, it will be on less than average volume. So this is a positive sign. When the stock is falling on volumes less than its average line, it is a very positive sign. So weak investors will go away here. Again, these investors who bought the stock over here would average it, and this particular price volume action will be so strong that the stock will clear its all-time high or pivot. So pivot is nothing but the previous resistance which the stock was facing. So once the stock crosses that previous resistance, that is called your breakout. And on the day when it will cross, you will see volumes will be extraordinarily high. It will be more than our average, and that's your exact, you know, buy point. And your buy range will be from pivot till 5%. Now pivot also, the software will tell you, if you just see the chart in the Markets in India app, you will see the pivot price, and you add 5% into that, that will be your buy zone. We'll talk about the sell zone as we go into the buying and selling. For the timing, we're just discussing the chart. Okay, there is a question which is coming repeatedly, which I think should have come at the end of the session, because that's not so much important now. That where can we get the stock market historic data? So if you just Google, there also you will get the historic data. But for your information, you can go into BSE or NSE's website. From there, you can check the historic data of all the stock. And for 3 years, I think it's available in Markets with India app also. For pattern formation also, you will get all those things in our Markets with India app. You will be provided free subscription of Markets with India app for your competition. You can you are expected to use that, and I'll come to that part later on. What you have to do for the competition. Again, I request kindly don't break the flow by asking questions which could be asked later on, because I don't want to, you know, break this particular topic because it's a very important topic. Okay, so what are the checklists for a cup with a handle based pattern? There should be a prior uptrend of at least 30%. The base formation will happen in at least 7 weeks, so it can be more also. The handle must form in the upper half of the cup. So if you see handle, it is forming in the upper half. You don't want a handle to be like this. It should not. I'll just draw it for you. So we don't want a handle which is like this. This is not that great a handle. We want the handle to form in the upper half of the base. Okay. So this is the weekly chart of KEI Industries, which made a cup with a handle base pattern. Now let's see if everything is all the checklist is being fulfilled or not. So the stock had a prior uptrend of 30% till here. This entire thing happened in 7 weeks. The second thing is also fulfilled. Handle must form in the upper half of the base. It's forming in the upper half of the base. Volume is decreasing in the middle. So I forgot to tell you this, that when there will be a base formation, when the stock will fall over here, the volumes will be drying up. And as I told you, that's a good signal that weak investors are moving out, not institutional investors. Institutional investor would have bought the stock here. You know, they would be averaging over here and again buying it when the stock is near the resistance, so that the stock clears its resistance and move into new highs. And retail investors, weak investors would come out, and that it will show up in the chart in the form of stock falling down on below average volume. So volume decreases in the middle, and the buy point is 5% within the high of the base. So that's your pivot, and from pivot you add 5%, that is your buy point. And this particular point is your breakout point, when it is breaking out, clearing. And if you see the volumes, it's on, it's above average. This is the average line and it's higher. We'll see some more charts for a clarity. This is the chart of Godal Chemicals, which gave 200% return in almost 40 weeks, which is less than a year from buy point. So this particular stock had a breakout over here. If you see the breakout point, again, the volumes were above average. And from here, the stock rallied almost 200% in just 40 weeks. It's a daily chart of Godal Chemicals, where you can easily see the buy point. So this is your buy point, because it's called the breakout. Now in the Market Smith India app, you can easily see the breakout point, buy point, and all those things. So this is the second base, which is a double bottom. The entire formation checklist is same. Again, uptrend of 30%, depth of 15 to 35%. Here again, people buying the stock, selling, weak investors selling it again. Again, there is a selling. The ones who have bought here or would have bought here are again selling over here. Then strong, big money institutional investors are buying the stock over here, and ultimately the stock breaks out. So buy point will be the middle pick of the W. If you see this, it looks like a W. It's a double bottom, one bottom, second bottom. It's the buy point will be above this, and this will be your area of resistance. When the stock will clear the area of resistance, it will be called as double bottom. Let's see some examples. So this is the chart of Cupid, which, you know, broke out in June 2015. If you see, this is the breakout point, and it, you know, just see the volumes. It before breakout, you could see a strong accumulation happening, and suddenly there is a big spike, a gap up opening, and stock went into new high. So this particular stock gave 290% in just 23 weeks, which is 60%. That's the power of, you know, that's the power of a breakout, and that's why we tend to pick up growth stocks, which is in the up momentum. It's a weekly chart of Ashok Leland. See, this particular stock made a cup with a handle. There is a small handle. It's a weekly chart, so it's not that much prominent. There is a double bottom right after this breakout. The stock rallied again. There is a base formation, because someone would have made a good amount here, so you know they would be booking there. So this is how you build a long-term portfolio in CashSlim. You would buy a stock, the stock will go up 25-30%, then again it will kind of make a new base where it will fall down. So you know you have to sit tight until, unless you don't have a 8% loss, because that's one of the sell rule. If a stock falls by 8% or more, you should not hold it. You should cut down your position. So that's one of the sell rule. Now 62% return in 32 weeks from buy point. So this is your daily chart of Ashok Leyland, where it broke out over here, and the volumes were above average. There was a gap up opening, which is again a very positive signal. So this is a flat base, which is the third one. In flat base, again the same thing will happen. However, here the prior uptrend will be 20%, the depth will be less than 15%, and stock will trade in a channel. So this is the area of resistance, this is the area of support. Stock will just kind of touch the resistance, come down, touch the resistance, come down, and ultimately there will be a day when the volumes will be so much that the stock will kind of break out. So again, a prior uptrend of at least 30% should be there. Base occurs over at least 5 weeks. Price range during base is less than 15%. Volume dry up, shake out, identify the buy point and breakout. On the breakout day, the volume should be 50% more than the average volume. A chart of Maruti Suzuki. So So this line means that there is a flat base pattern. The stock broke out at this particular point. The volumes were on above average line, and from there this again surged. So stock gave 24% in 6 weeks. And Maruti giving 24% in just 6 weeks is a big thing because it's a heavily weighted cap stock. And if Maruti is giving 24% in 6 weeks, that means Nifty would have also given a very strong return. So daily chart of a blue star, again there is a breakout over here. Again, see, just during the breakout, near to the breakout, the stock will go up on above average volume, which is a kind of very good signal. So it gave 70% return in 1 year or. It is the daily chart which is more prominent. So we can just see the breakout point here. Now, what are the checklist of buying stocks? First of all, check the market, whether the market is in a confirmed uptrend or not. If the market is in a confirmed uptrend, go ahead. Find the stock you are watching come from the industry group that is showing strength. So that means that pick up the stock from the sector which is expected to do good. So when you are preparing the stock pitch report, so we want to see that you have a reason why this particular sector will do good in the Indian market currently. So go do a good top-down analysis and find the sectors which are expected to do good. Now, in the buying stocks checklist, you should check the fundamentals, which is your C and A of CanSim. Earnings growth of 25% or more in the past 2 quarters. Earnings growth of 25% or more in each of the past 3 to 5 years. Firm's profit margin should be higher than the peer group, and return on equity should be 17%. Now, this absolute number is derived from backtesting. So 17% or more is the ROE which we are looking for. However, in Indian market, you can go down from till 14. So it should be above 14%. In technical analysis, basically check for the base pattern. There should be a base pattern and a breakout point. Then you get into the stock. And how you can identify is in our MarketSmith India app, you can go and type the name of the stock. We will be providing you the name of the stocks. Among them, you have to shortlist few stocks and prepare the pitch. So it will be very easy for you. You can just type the name and see which base patterns they are making. Once you see that the stock is near pivot or it's just close to pivot, you can prepare the stock pitch. And you can just go ahead and do the company's analysis, use the company's balance sheet and annual reports. Read the annual report of the last 2-3 years, prepare your reports. Do not copy from any website. So this is now we'll talk about section 3, how you can use the charts to time your selling. Now this is also important because selling is a tougher decision compared to buying. What to buy, a lot of people will tell you, but what to sell is something which no one tells you. So there are three reasons to sell a stock. First is protect capital, which is the 8% sell rule, which I have already told you that once you buy the stock at a breakout and the stock starts falling down, the maximum loss you can bear is 8%. You come out of the stock because that is a failed breakout, and when the market is big, we'll have a lot of failed breakout. Second is lock-in profit. In lock-in profit, you have two things. You're already sitting at a profit. Suddenly, you see that stock is breaching its 50-day or 200-day moving average line. In that case, sell the stock and take whatever profits you have got. Another thing is selling into strength, which means the stock has already surged 25-30%. You think that it's a good amount of profit for you, you can just take that profit and invest that money into other stocks. The third reason to sell is the distribution in the general market, or when the market is degraded from confirmed uptrend to uptrend under pressure, or from uptrend under pressure to correction. Just for your information, currently market is in rally attempt and it's trying to get into rally, but it's not able to get it. So even the market status you will be able to see in MarketSmith India app. So always cut your losses short at 8% from the purchase price. So what if the stock suddenly falls more than 8%? Say for example, in the morning you see the stock is just gapping down. In that case, it's better to sell as early as possible, because if a stock is opening 10-15% gap down, you can't do much about it. But don't wait for those stocks to come up. During that particular day, you can see if it is recovering. However, if in 2-3 trading session it is continuously falling down, sell the stock. So this is the weekly chart of Tata Motors, where the buy point was at 544. It was a case of a failed breakout. The breakout happened here and the stock fell down. So in this case, if you know, we recommend people to come out at 500. 544 was a buy point, 8% is 40 rupees. So roughly, sorry, I mean, from 500 was our 8% stop loss. So roughly we asked people to come out here, and ultimately we would have preserved capital because we are selling the stock here, and ultimately it went down to 297. So this is the kind of fall which can happen if you are not coming out of the, not following the 8% stop loss rule. Now, locking in profit is institutional selling. If you see that you are already sitting in a, on a profit, and at the stock is falling on an above average volume, this is the above average volume selling. So on three, it's happening. That means the institutions are slowly selling the stock, dumping the shares in the market. That means the growth story is not there. You know, their research is over. They feel that the research, I mean, the target for which they bought the stock is over. So it's good to come out with them. The second is breaking key support level. Again, if institutional selling will happen more often than not, the stock will breach its 50-day moving average or 200-day moving average. So that will be like, you know, a good signal to sell the stock. The third is gap down. As I told you, gap down is, you know, on the chart you will see that stock will kind of go out of the range it was trading on its previous day. Say for example, if in the candle if you see, say this is the trading range, and on the other day you see it's just going up or going down from that range. That means it's a going up on that range is a bullish signal. Like Yes Bank, which has, if you see Yes Bank charts today, you will see a gap up. That's a very bullish signal, and if a stock is falling down, it's gap down, it's a negative sign. So in lock-in profits, take most profits when a stock has risen 20 to 25%. Now there is an exception to this rule, which says William O'Neill says that when a stock rallies 20% or more in just first 3 weeks, in that case you should hold the stock for at least 8 weeks. Now the reason for it is that we have observed that most of the multi-bagged stocks fall under this criteria. They increases 20% in just first 3 weeks, and ultimately went on to become a, you know, big multi-bagger. HEG gave a 20% return in just first 3 weeks, and ultimately, you know, it became a multi-bagger. It gives 8 times in just 8 months. Now, general market direction is distribution day in key indexes. General market direction is just down, current position in market cycle. Now this is not that important. What you need to know is sell the stock when it is correction, buy the stock when it is confirmed uptrend. In rally attend and uptrend under pressure, remain selective, buy only strong stock. So unfortunately currently the market is in rally attempt, so I mean we won't suggest buying much stock, but then we do add stocks because if we have very good conviction about any stock. Currently, we'll send you the list of the stocks, and you know, you need to do the research and send the report. We will tell you how much reports you need, how much stock which you need to prepare. So some of the key pitfalls which you need to avoid is look for institutional quality stocks, look for liquid stocks, because for an illiquid stocks, you know, you will kind of, it will be difficult for you to sell off. Third is avoid charts with good technicals but weak fundamentals, because fundamental is a very strong, fundamentals should be a basic criteria, and if fundamentals are weak, avoid the stock. Fourth is the general market direction. If the general market direction is weak, don't buy the stock. So that's all, and we'll provide the recording for this particular webinar. And what you need to do, we will send you the name of the stocks. You need to prepare 3 investment cases, and you need to pitch anyone on the final day. So we will send the name of the stocks. You need to select from that list. You need to select any 3 stocks. And for the deadlines, you will receive the mail from IIT Kanpur. So if you have any questions now, it will be taking it. So all the things you will get in our, if you can see here, this is our app. You can download it. Download the MarketSmith India app. And once you have downloaded the app, we expect everyone, the ones who are participating, kindly download the app by today. And by tomorrow, we want the email IDs of all the participants. Once we receive it from IIT Kanpur, we will get the premium version activated, because all the features you will not be able to see in the free version. However, you will be able to see the charts in the free version. So it's available. You can access it in your desktop, iPad. It's there in Google Play as well as App Store. And you can follow us in MarketSmith India in Twitter, in LinkedIn, as well as in Facebook. And if you're interested in knowing more about the buy and sell rules about CanSlim, we have a YouTube page, MarketSmith India. That's, you can go there, subscribe to it, and you can see that we do a bi-weekly webinar. So, you know, we keep on coming with new ideas, coming up with the new O'Neill's methodology. There is a lot into O'Neill's methodology. It's difficult to cover it in one day. So he has written a book called How to Make Money in Stocks. So we try to cover different topics through that bi-weekly webinar. So if you have any questions, kindly put it in the chat box.